Australia's relationship with China appears to have hit a fresh snag. Beijing warning it will retaliate against countries imposing new COVID testing rules on its travellers. With the measure set to come into effect here in a matter of hours, Treasurer Jim Chalmers has brushed off the threat.
As queues grow for a bed in Shanghai's crowded hospitals, tensions are growing over the international response to China's new COVID wave. From midnight, Australia will join more than a dozen countries enforcing new testing rules on travellers.
We think that this is a modest measure, simply asking people who are getting on a plane, coming here from China, to have a PCR test or a RAT test.
The Chinese government thinks it's discrimination, a spokesperson saying it lacks scientific basis, and warning we will take countermeasures to reciprocate.
China is threatening countermeasures. Does that worry you?
Oh, look, not especially.
The government says it's doing it out of an abundance of caution.
If they take any steps in response to the responsible steps we've taken, then that will be a matter for them. I'm not going to try and kind of preempt or guess what they might do.
But it's a step not recommended by the chief medical officer.
The Prime Minister has made a political judgment. But that political judgment is not lockstep with the medical advice.
If there's a reason, we're all ears. And I think even the Chinese would be all ears.
Labor says it's following advice from the World Health Organization, which has concerns China's not being transparent over its COVID data.
The Chinese embassy here in Canberra has refused to comment on what this latest development will mean for diplomatic ties between China and Australia. But previously, Beijing has hit back over disagreements with billions of dollars worth of trade sanctions.
The relationship has only recently started to steady after years on rocky ground.
We, of course, want to see that relationship stabilised, but at the same time, we have a responsibility to take the steps that are necessary to keep the Australian people safe.
Hoping this will be no more than a bump in the road. Fiona Willen, Nine News.
Well, it's a decision that's been branded silly application of caution and totally pointless. And it appears the move to impose mandatory COVID testing on travellers from China is already causing a rift, not just between Australia's top medical professionals and our government, but of course with China as well.
Planted firmly against the decision is Australia's former Deputy Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Nick Coatsworth, and he joins us now from Canberra. Dr. Nick, thanks for your time. Now, you did share a tweet that inferred this was discriminatory politics. Why do you so firmly believe that this was a wrong call and not just being cautious?
Well, Christine, there'll be viewers watching that have some sympathy for this policy to test travellers from China. But what I'd say to people, I guess, is that, you know, there's about 1.3 billion people in China. There's another 6.5 billion people in the world. And we're not testing people from other countries. We're also at a phase in the pandemic where we think it's safe largely for COVID-19 to circulate within the community, provided that we give medical care to those who need it the most, that we encourage people to mask up when they're symptomatic and that they test. And that's the limit of the advice that the Chief Medical Officer of Australia is giving. And I do think it's concerning in matters of biosecurity when you have your Chief Medical Officer, your Chief Biosecurity Officer for Health, recommending one thing and then a government bringing in a higher level of restrictions. That's not a great precedent for us to be setting, I don't think.
Dr. Nick, the argument against, the argument for treating those 1.5 billion people in China different is that the other 6.5 billion people. We know what's happening with the virus in their country. We don't in China. The World Health Organization says that. The United States, the UK both say that. So that's why they're being treated differently. Should there be some balance, something in the middle that says that we need to know what's happening inside China's border before we treat them like the rest of the world?
And that's a perfect assessment, Charles. But the problem is that a rapid antigen test won't give you any information that's useful to determine what's actually going on in China. I mean, we've got great technology, great labs in Australia that do the genetic sequencing to find the variants. So why wouldn't you offer voluntary PCR testing to Chinese travellers coming in so we can determine, and in fact any travellers coming in, so we can determine the variants that are coming into Australia? That's what we want to do. And to be honest, there's different variants circulating in the United States at the moment. It's a sad indictment on this pandemic that the two countries that fluffed the pandemic the most were the two superpowers, US and China. Mm-hmm. But if we're going to put restrictions on China, then for consistency, we should do it for the US. But as it happens, I don't think we should have travel restrictions on either of those nations.
Well, the promise of a new high school for Western Sydney is at the centre of Labor's election pitch for the seats of Ryde and Parramatta. Opposition leader Chris Minns hoping to get on the front foot in what will be a key battleground.
Fresh from a Christmas holiday, the opposition leader launched straight into campaign mode.
Nice to meet you.
By his side, two newly minted candidates for Ryde and Parramatta, as Labor hopes to snatch the key seats, both currently held by retiring Liberal ministers.
Western Sydney is going to be a key battleground, and the reason for that is that many people that live in this part of New South Wales feel left behind by the government.
And it's parents at the centre of Chris Minns's big pitch, a new high school in Melrose Park on the border of Parramatta and West Ryde.
My daughter is going to Hull Ryde High School. When we have a high school here, you know, like it will be more easier for us.
The government has already committed to redeveloping Melrose Park Public and is in the final stages of buying a site to build a new high school.
They're playing catch up with government policy. What Labor really should be talking about is whether they're going to build Parramatta Light Rail Stage 2.
With the retirement of Minister Jeff Lee, the Liberals are yet to field a candidate here in Parramatta, leaving whoever they choose less than 12 weeks to campaign against Labor's already well-known pick. The ALP installing outspoken Parramatta Mayor Donna Davis as its contender, but in Ryde the opposition is on the back foot. Teacher Lyndall Howison, the party's second announcement, their first, was forced to pull out of the race after an alleged domestic violence incident, which he denies.
I can't offer and won't offer a running commentary in relation to that, other than to say that there's no place for domestic violence.
Now, with his contenders finalised, the Minns team is on the march in Western Sydney. Liz Daniels, Nine News.
With the Australian Open around the corner and Elton John touring Melbourne in 2023, sport and music fans are being warned to be wary of scamming scalpers. As Mark Santamartino explains, more Victorians are losing a small fortune buying fake tickets.
Patrick Meehan spent almost $600 for three tickets to see Billy Bragg in concert. Once upon a time at home. Three tickets Patrick was never sent and probably never existed.
It wasn't fun paying a lot of money and not getting those tickets.
And Patrick isn't alone. More than 1,100 Victorians who were scammed by resellers complained to Consumer Affairs last financial year. That's an increase on pre-pandemic levels, and in most cases, by the time a buyer realises their money is lost for good.
And I would always caution people not to pay a direct transfer into somebody's bank account online, because you cannot recover the money if something goes wrong.
Harry Styles, Elton John and the Red Hot Chili Peppers will all tour Australia this year. And the Arctic Monkeys are playing Melbourne's Sydney Meyer Music Bowl tonight. But if you Google last-minute tickets, an ad from Viagogo appears first, a reseller with a checkered history of selling fake or overpriced tickets. In 2019, Australia's federal court found Viagogo guilty of misleading consumers, and the company has since lost an appeal against a $7 million fine.
If the original terms and conditions are that people are not allowed to pass on or resell the tickets, you could find yourself getting blocked.
It's illegal to resell any ticket in Victoria for 10% more than the original asking price, but that still routinely happens online, and the government won't rule out making tougher changes.
We don't want people to miss out. We don't want people to be taken advantage of.
You never know if you're going to get scammed. It's not a pretty feeling.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.